this lesson, you will learn how to connect a CI server with ALM Octane. For the demonstration, we will be using Jenkins. So let's start. First, we need to generate an API access in ALM Octane in order to allow the CI server to connect to Octane. To generate CI server API access, we need to go to Settings, to Spaces. From here, we need to go to the Space level and select API access. Here you can see all the APIs you have already been using. To generate a new access, click on API access, give it a name, provide a role CI/CD. For the workspaces, you would like to integrate the CI. It is possible to integrate with one single workspace or even with multiple. We will integrate only with one workspace. Press OK and say Add. Now copy this information to a place where you will find it. I will copy it into the API access description and save it. So now we have generated an API access for our Jenkins server. Let's move to the Jenkins server and try to connect with our ALM Octane instance using this API access. Now go to the project. And go to the section DevOps. Under the section CI servers, on the right hand side, you'll find a download button. Click on the link for Jenkins and you will be redirected to the Jenkins plugins page for the ALM Octane plugin. From here, download the latest version. Here you can download the latest version. So once the version is downloaded, go to Jenkins. In Jenkins Plugin Manager, click on Advanced. Select the file which has been downloaded and upload and install it. Once the plugin is installed, you will see under Jenkins, Manage Jenkins, Configure System, you will see a section for ALM Octane CI. On my CI server, Jenkins, I have already a connection configured for my ALM Octane server. I will add now an additional connection to it. So let's do it together. Enter here the location of your ALM Octane server. I will use the IP address and also the link to my project. Now enter the CI client ID and CI client secret. Let's grab it from ALM Octane. So I have entered now the client secret and client ID. So the user I will be using to connect from Jenkins to ALM Octane. Now let's see if this connection is working. Click on Test Connection. And here you will receive connection successful. After this, save the connection and go to ALM Octane. In ALM Octane, now try to add a CI server. And we will see in the CI server list, I have already one entry which is available. I can select it, give it a logical name, server, add, and now you can see this server has been added. I can see it is connected to Octane. If I click on the link, it should redirect me to the server page, which is fine. So this connection has been set up. And as a next step, in the next video, we will see how you can add a job as a pipeline in ALM Octane.